From the newsroom at news.com.au. This is the latest from the newsroom. It's Monday, the 27th of December. New South Wales has recorded its first Omicron death as case numbers continue to rise. The man in his 80s from Western Sydney died at Westmead Hospital after contracting the virus at United Lillian Wells Aged Care Facility. The death comes as new restrictions come into force, with Premier Dominique Perrottet stressing the importance of getting vaccinated.
It's very clear from ICU presentations that the majority of people who are in ICU are unvaccinated. That is at a time when 95% of our people here in New South Wales have received their first dose vaccination. So the numbers don't lie.
Meanwhile, in Queensland, Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk has announced that parents can now book COVID-19 vaccinations for their 5 to 11-year-olds, with jabs for this age group available from January 10. Channel 7 has been forced to make several changes to its commentary team for the third Ashes test after a member of staff working on the broadcast tested positive to COVID-19. Channel 7 released a statement confirming the roster of callers would be completely different from the previous day, with Channel 7 presenter Trent Copeland sharing a post that he is waiting for test results and watching on from the hotel. Tributes are flowing for a 5-year-old boy who died after a Gold Coast dog attack on Christmas Eve. Family and friends have rallied around the single dad, raising funds for the funeral, with one friend describing his love for his son was immeasurable. Investigations into the tragedy are set to be launched by the Gold Coast Council and the coroner. To sport, COVID and wild weather are causing carnage on the Sydney to Hobart yacht race, which has seen multiple boats drop out of the race within the first 24 hours. In entertainment news, Amber Heard has welcomed a new furry member to her family with a name familiar to Aussies. Heard shared a photo of her new dog, Barnaby Joyce, on Twitter. It comes 6 years after the politician famously threatened to put down both of her dogs after Heard and her ex-husband, Johnny Depp, broke strict quarantine rules for animals by bringing their two dogs into the country. And in a heartwarming Christmas gesture, Arnold Schwarzenegger has bought 25 houses for homeless veterans. That's the latest from the newsroom. We'll be back with another update soon.
Get the latest from news.com.au.